Space is vast, and everything is really far away from everything else. So how do we navigate to and precisely land on other worlds? Let's find out in this episode of How to Build a Spaceship. The suite of instruments needed to know exactly where a spacecraft is in space and how to get it from point A to point B is known as GNC, Guidance, Navigation, and Control. Guidance systems are used to determine the trajectory a spacecraft will take to get to its destination, accounting for any changes in velocity, rotation, and acceleration necessary to keep the spacecraft on that path. Navigation systems tell you exactly where your spacecraft is at any moment. But in space, we don't have GPS like we have here on Earth on your phone, since GPS relies on satellites in Earth orbit to function. Instead, we navigate by the stars using a tool called a star tracker. Honeywell's key components for guidance, navigation, and control are inertial measurement units, or IMUs, and gyros. These guidance and navigation products have been integral to some pretty cool spacecraft, like the OSIRIS-REx mission, which is currently at the asteroid Bennu, or the New Horizons mission, which precisely navigated thanks to Honeywell technology for 9 years to reach and explore Pluto, and the Mars InSight lander. If you thought parallel parking was hard, you've never had to deal with 7 minutes of terror trying to land a lander on another planet. I understand acceleration from riding in cars, but how do you measure spinning?
You can use two different things. We have MEMS, which is a chip that includes both electronical and mechanical items. If you use for less accurate items, you would use a MEMS. If you would need a more accurate measurement, you can use laser beam gyros or fiber optic gyros.
So do you have sensors for each of those parameters?
We do. We have two. We have gyroscopes, which could be aligned on all three axes, X, Y, and Z. With those, you can measure how much you're rotating. With an accelerometer, they measure acceleration. And they're also placed on all three sides, X, Y, and Z.
Hi, I'm Esther Colon, and I'm a proud space nerd.
These are gyros sound cool, but how do they measure spinning? Don't lasers travel in a straight line?
We have two lasers that go in opposite directions in a circle, both traveling the same distance, but then the time that it takes to travel as we detect motion is what allows us to detect what kind of angular rate and position that the unit or device is moving in. And that's called the Sagnac effect.
The landing of Mars InSight, known as the 7 minutes of terror, involves some pretty key Honeywell technology. Can you tell me more about that?
So in all the landings, and Honeywell has been part of most of the Mars landers, and that 7 minutes of terror is because it's all instrument driven. We don't have enough time due to the delay in the communication to make any quick adjustments so that we can land successfully. So at that point, they just hit the button and go, and then they pray that it'll land properly. I'm Jeremy Lutis, and I am a proud space nerd. And I have things on Mars.
And that's how we accurately navigate through space. Now, if only I could figure out how to accurately navigate back to the conference room.